Hey, my name is Felipe and welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to work with DeepFace, which is a very powerful Python library in order to do face recognition and face analysis. Now, let me show you what are the three use cases in which we will be working today. We are going to use DeepFace in order to do face matching. This means we are going to input two faces and we are going to verify if these two faces belong to the same person or not. Then, another use case for which we are going to be using DeepFace is to find a face in a database of many other faces of many other people. This is a much more complex problem and we will be approaching this problem with DeepFace as well. And then we are also going to use DeepFace in order to do face analysis. We are going to input a person's face and we are going to classify its age, emotion, gender and race. So these are the three use cases in which we will be working today and we are going to approach all these problems using DeepFace. So let me show you how to do it. Now let's go to Pycharm. This is a Pycharm project I created for this tutorial. And before you get started, please remember to install DeepFace, which is the Python library we will be using today. Please remember to install this package, otherwise nothing is going to work. And now let's get started. Let's get started over here in main.py. This is a file I created and this is where we are going to be doing all the coding of this project. So the first thing I'm going to do is to write the three use cases I just mentioned, which are face matching. Then we are also going to find face in database. And then we're going to do face analysis. Okay, now let me show you something else. Let me show you the data I have prepared in order to work on this project. And these are some pictures we are going to use in order to test this library. You can see that these are two pictures of me. So this is me and this is also me. And we're going to use DeepFace in order to verify if these two pictures belong to the same person or not. And then I have also prepared other images. And these are images of other guys which are definitely not me, but they kind of look like me, maybe. I try to find some pictures of other guys which kind of look like me, so we can also use DeepFace in order to verify if these pictures belong to the same person or not. We are going to input one of my pictures and one of these pictures, and we are going to see what happens. And then I have also prepared another image, which is this one, which is an image I generated in one of those online tools for person generation or face generation, and this is an image of me but at a much older age, right? This is a picture of me but with more than 60 years old. We are going to use this picture as well in order to verify if the face matching works properly or not. We are going to input one of my pictures and then we're also going to input this picture over here and we're going to see what happens. We're going to see if these two pictures belong to the same person or not, because technically they do belong to the same person. So it's going to be very interesting to see what happens in this case. Now let's get back to Pycharm. This is the data we are going to use in order to test this tutorial. And now let's get started with the face matching. The first thing we need to do is to import from DeepFace, import DeepFace, and that's going to be pretty much all. Now, in order to do the face matching, let's get back to this GitHub repository over here. And the only thing I'm going to do is to copy and paste this instruction we have over here. I'm going to copy and paste, and that's going to be pretty much all. This is going to be super, super simple. So let me show you. You can see we have two parameters, which are image one pod and image two pod. And this is the pod to the images we are going to use in order to verify if they belong to the same person or not. So the only thing I'm going to do is to set the image pod as Felipe1.png and Felipe2.png. And that's going to be pretty much all. And then I'm going to print result. But the only thing I'm going to do in order to make it look prettier, I'm going to import JSON. And then I'm going to print JSON.dumps. Result, and then indent 2. This is going to be exactly the same. We are going to print result, but we're going to make it look much nicer if we do it like this. And that's going to be all. The only thing I'm going to do now is to execute this instruction over here. Please notice we are executing this function with all the default parameters. The only thing we are specifying is the location of the two images we are going to verify, and that's it. That's the only thing we are specifying. Then we're just using all the default parameters. Let's see what happens. I'm going to press play. And this is what we got. Let me show you. You can see it says verify equal true, which means these two pictures belong to the same person, which is true, right? Because these two pictures are both about me. And you can see that we also get all this information, right? Similarity metric, detector backend, model, threshold, and so on. We are not going to mind all this information in this tutorial. This is only to show you a very quick and a very easy and a very high level way to do face matching. So we are not going to mind all this additional information. We're only going to focus here on if these two pictures match or not. But in order to show you super quickly what all these other keys mean, right, all this information, what they mean, let me show you in GitHub. Let's go to this function code. Remember, DeepFace is open source, so all the code is available in GitHub, and this is the function we are currently using, which is verify. You can see it receives these two parameters, image1 pod and image2 pod, and then it also receives these other parameters you can see over here. And these three parameters, distance metric, detector backend, and model name, these parameters have to do with the way DeepFace is doing the face detection and the face recognition. Because remember, the pictures we are using, they contain a face, but they are actually pictures of an entire person, right? So the first step in this process will be to do face detection, and then DeepFace is going to do face recognition. And this is why we have these parameters over here. We can choose different backends, different detectors in order to do the face detection, and we can also choose different ways to do the face recognition, right? This is only like a very, very high level explanation. I'm not going into the details, but just remember there are different parameters which control the way DeepFace is doing the face detection and the face recognition, and we are not really setting anything for those parameters, right? We're just using all the default parameters, because I only want to show you how everything works from a super, super high level. Let's see what happens if we input one of the other functions which are not me. Let's start with not Felipe1. .jpg, and let's see what happens. In this case, it says verify equal false, so they do not belong to the same person, which is right, right? They don't belong to the same person, so everything is okay. Now let's continue with not Felipe2. In this case, we got verify equal false as well. Remember, not Felipe2 is this picture over here. So yeah, it's all right, because this picture is definitely not me. Now let's try with not Felipe3, and let's see what happens. In this case, we got verify equal false, so far everything is okay. And now let's try with not Felipe4. And in this case, we also got verify equal false, so everything is okay for these four examples over here. And only like a very quick note, I got these pictures from Pixels, because I was looking for royalty-free pictures, but I have also tried one of those online tools for what's the celebrity you look the most, and then I just tried with some of the results I got from these tools, and I got similar results. In all cases I tried, I got verify equal false, so for all the tests I have done so far, this works as expected. This works very well. So yeah, this is exactly how you can use DeepFace for face matching, and the results I got so far, they are very well. Now let's try with the other one, which is Felipe Older, and let's see what happens, because remember, technically this is me, but at a much older age. We are going to compare this picture over here with this picture over here, and technically this should be a match, because technically this is the same person. Let's see what happens. I'm just going to execute this script again. And in this case, we got verify equal false. So according to DeepFace, these pictures do not belong to the same person. I think this is a very interesting example, because technically they are from the same person, but this is the result we got with all the default parameters. Remember, there are many other parameters we can select over here. We can definitely play around with this function, with all the parameters and so on. And maybe for some other combination of parameters, we could have a situation in which these two pictures match as the same person. But only like a very quick note, there are some algorithms for face matching which are made to deal with this particular situation, which is the same person but different age, right? There are some very specific algorithms which are made exactly for that very specific purpose, and those algorithms are the ones that deal with this type of situation. So this was only a very quick note, but if you look at this problem from a different perspective, then this is not necessarily a mistake. Saying these two pictures don't belong to the same person is not necessarily a mistake, because there are some cases of people who look alike and they have different ages and they are not the same person, right? For example, this could be this person's father, or this could be this person's relative, and yeah, they are different people but they look alike, so that's not necessarily a mistake. It all depends on your use case, on your application, on why are you doing this face matching, right, and what's your goal, but this could be a mistake or not. Anyway, I thought this was a very cool example in order to test this function, and this is the result I got with all the default parameters. Remember, we could apply other face detection technologies, other face recognition parameters, we could do the face recognition differently in order to have different results, but for now this is the results we got. The only detail I'm going to show you in this from all this information we got over here is this one over here, which is distance. In order to give you a super high level explanation, the lower this value means the pictures are closer together. The lower this value means the pictures are more similar, right? And we also have this other parameter, which is threshold, and you can see it's 0.68, and this means that everything that's above 0.68 is going to be considered that it's not a match, and everything that's below 0.68 is going to be considered that it is a match. And in this case, this is higher than 0.68, but it's not really that higher, right? If we change this value, for example, if we change the threshold and we make the threshold much higher, then these two pictures are going to be considered a match. Anyway, long story short, we could definitely apply different parameters and different configurations in order to change the results, in order to make these two pictures to be a match, but in the default parameters, this is not the case. And now let's continue with the next use case, which is finding a face in a database. And this is how we are going to do. I'm going to comment these two instructions here, because now we're going to focus on the on this part, which is finding a face in a database. And this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to create a directory which is database, and then I'm just going to take all these pictures over here, and I'm going to put all these pictures here in database. Okay, then we are going to find this face, or actually this person's face, in this database, and let's see what happens. So let's get back here to this GitHub repository. The only thing I'm going to do, the same way we did before, the only thing I'm going to do is to copy and paste this instruction over here, and this is going to be all. I'm going to use all the default parameters as well. So I'm just going to type Felipe1png, and then the DB path will be DB. Okay. And now I'm just going to execute it. I'm going to print DFS. And that's going to be pretty much all. Let's see what happens when executing this instruction, and then we are just going to print all the results. Let's see what happens. Okay, and this is the result. You can see that this is what we got. This is the match we found, which is Felipe2.png, which is exactly what we should, right? We found that this is the match, so everything is okay. Now, let's continue with the next use case, which is the face analysis. This is where we are going to input a face, and we are going to classify the person's age, the person's gender, the person's emotion, and the person's race. So let's see what happens. I'm going to, the same way we did before, I'm going to copy and paste this instruction over here, analyze. And as I want to execute all the functions with the default parameters, I'm going to remove this part over here. So we're just going to input the image path, and that's going to be all. I want to make everything as simple as possible, because that's one of the things I want to show you in this tutorial. How simple it is to use this library in order to do face recognition and face analysis. Only executing an instruction which you can just copy and paste from the GitHub repository, and without specifying any parameters whatsoever, you can have some very, very super decent results. So this is one of the things I want to show you in this tutorial. And now I'm going to print result, I'm going to print objects, and let's do exactly the same as we did over here, so everything is going to look nicer, and let's see what happens. Okay, now let's see the results. I'm going to open the picture again, so we can verify if the information makes sense or not. It says emotion equal to, you can see we have all these different emotions, and we have a value for each one of these emotions. You can read this number as a percentage, right? So in this case, this is 0%. In this case, this is 100%. You can read this number as if they were a percentage. And in all these other cases, this is like, this is not zero, but this is very close to zero, right? These are very, very, very super low numbers. So yeah, basically it says happy 100%, and it makes sense because this is a picture of me smiling, so everything makes sense so far. It says dominant emotion, happy, so everything is okay. This is the face region, so I'm not going to verify this information, but let's assume everything is okay. Then the age, 34, okay. Gender, man, and almost a 100%, so everything is okay. Then race, you can see we have different options over here: Asian, Indian, Black, White, Middle Eastern, and Latino Hispanic. And you can see in my case, it says I'm white with a 99.4% accuracy. And then it says I'm Middle Eastern with a 0.5% and Latino with a 0.04%. I'm not sure if I agree with this classification. I think I disagree a little. I think I'm a little more Latino Hispanic. Maybe 50% white and 50% Latin Hispanic, but anyway, it doesn't matter. So these are the results we got, and this is exactly how you can execute this function in order to classify a person's emotion, age, gender, and race. So this is going to be pretty much all for this tutorial. Remember, this video was about DeepFace and was about showing you how simple, how straightforward it is to use DeepFace in order to do face recognition and face analysis. You can see that in each one of these cases, we were able to execute this function with only one instruction. Only one instruction was enough in order to do face recognition and face analysis. So this is how simple it is to use this library, and this is why I like it so much. So this is going to be all for this tutorial. My name is Felipe. I'm a computer vision engineer, and see you on my next video.